Welcome back. My name is Lexi Jong, and here I like to talk about luxury makeup. Today we have another episode of Makeup Mondays, and I'm actually coupling that topic with the review of the new Rouge Dior lip balm. And that's because today we are talking all about lip balms. Now, today's video goes out to quite a few of you who have asked for a video on favorite lip balms. So what we're going to do is I'm going to start off with a review on the new Rouge Dior lip balm, and then we're going to go ahead and discuss my favorite lip balms. So let's get started. So the Rouge Dior lip balm comes in a traditional Dior lipstick box, but we do have a white top, and it says 000 Dior Natural Satin Balm on it. And on the front of the box, it also tells you that it's a floral care lip balm. And that's because one of the things they are promoting on here is the use of peony and pomegranate flower extract. And that's supposed to be a little bit more soothing and offer some hydration to your lips as well. And according to this, it offers 16-hour comfort. And it says it was tested on 30 subjects. So this lip balm here, can see it also says it's rechargeable or refillable, so it is refillable packaging. This is the packaging. We have the CD on the top and along the belt in the middle, and then the inside of the cap is red, so it reminds me of like Louis Vuitton. And this is the actual lip balm here, so you can see that it's white, and a lot of times when we see a clear lip balm, it's more of like that light peachy nude shade. This is going to be, you can see the translucency towards the tip of this. So let me show you this lip balm on my hand. See that shine? That's one layer. And then just building it up there so you can make that a little bit thicker. So this lip balm, just to note, this is slightly rectangular. So you can see that you do need to make sure that you put the cap on properly. And the cap is a click closure. So this lip balm is 95% natural origin. And if you look at the website, it actually says that it offers 24-hour hydration as tested on 10 subjects. So the box says 16 hours for 30 subjects, and the website says 10 subjects, 24 hours. So we'll talk about that. And then some of the, I guess, the actual features of this lip balm that Dior is promoting. We've got the peony and pomegranate flower extract. We have a natural satin finish. And you can use this alone or under lipstick. They say you can wear this under any Dior lipstick and it will act not really as a primer, but it will improve like hydration and so forth and comfort on your lips. And the band here is actually to be reminiscent. They say it's a nod to the fitted waists of Dior's runway looks. And Dior has a new sustainability strategy, and that's why this packaging is refillable. Refills are not currently out yet. This retails for $38. So just by my own guess, I would say that the refills will be somewhere in the $20 to $25 range would be my guess. Now, this packaging, considering it's refillable, I actually thought it would be a little bit nicer than it is. This is plastic packaging, and I don't know, something like refillable that you're gonna refill a lot and a lot. I would have preferred this to be like metal or something, just a little bit, something a little bit sturdier. Cause I mean, not that you're going to be like super rough with your lip balm, but if for some reason this cap is on the floor, somebody steps on it, which could totally happen in my house, this will definitely crack. So, you know, you can actually, like if I'm doing this right now, you can see that it's actually flexing a little bit. So it's just, it's not the sturdiest material considering it is a refillable lip balm. Now, just something else to note, this is 3.5 grams or 0.12 ounces and it is made in France. I'm going to bring you in closer and apply the lip balm to my lips. I don't currently have anything on them, so we'll take a look at what you can actually see and how translucent this lip balm actually is. All right, so here's the lip balm, and you can see, especially when you're looking at the tip, the translucency in there. So it's definitely going to be a sheer lip balm. And we'll apply just a little bit more. So my thoughts on this lip balm, I think it is a very nice lip balm. It is very comfortable on my lips. It actually has more of a thin texture to it. And one of the very first ingredients on here is squalane. And if you have felt squalane before, which I'm sure most of you have, you know, it's very common in a lot of skincare ingredients right now. And that has a thin texture to it. And I think that's what gives the thinness to this particular product. So I'm looking at it and it's actually the second ingredient is squalane. So after that, we do have a lot of different waxes and things like sunflower seed wax. There is jojoba oil, there's beeswax, sweet almond oil, and so forth. So it is a very light, more moisturizing type of balm on the lips, and I find it to be very comfortable. I will have the ingredients listed down below in the description box if you are interested. Now, one other thing to note about this lip balm, there is a slight scent to it, and perfume is listed on the ingredients, and it is further down on the list. I'd say it's in the bottom third of the list, and it's not a super strong fragrance. It's a light floral scent. It's not bothersome to me. It's not something I notice on my lips, but I, you know, when I actually go to smell the lip balm, I do smell it. So I don't find it to be a bothersome scent, but there is fragrance in this lip balm. Now, as for the claims of 16-hour, 24-hour hydration, that's not really how my experience has gone. I've been using this for 10 days now, and I actually, for a couple days there, I let my lips get really kind of dried out. I didn't apply any lip balm for a couple of days to, you know, see how effective this was at kind of healing them. And I have to say that I find this to be a very thin, lightweight lip balm that's comfortable to wear. But for me, I feel like I have to reapply it every few hours. Now, when it does wear off and I don't feel any lip balm on, my lips do stay hydrated for a while, but I would not go so far as to say 16 hours or 24 hours. I feel like, you know, you've got like a few hours. So for me, I personally like to, I like the feeling of having lip balm on my lips. So I personally prefer to reapply this every couple of hours. But it is a thin, firm lip balm. So even with lots of use, I feel like you don't need like a ton of product on here. So this would still last quite a while. As for the actual finish of it, I really like it. I like the texture of it. I think it's a great lip balm. Now, as for healing properties, if you have lips that are in very dry, bad shape, this is not the kind of lip balm that you want to go for. And that, you know, I don't really feel like that was the intention behind this. This is not a heavy duty repair lip balm. This is one to give your lips that boost of hydration and to kind of maintain how their health is. And I have to say, I do think that it does that. It helps maintain it. It's comfortable. And, you know, if you are wearing this constantly, your lips do improve a little bit, but albeit a lot slower than it would with something a little bit thicker and more heavy duty. So for the purpose of daily hydration, I find this to be a great lip balm, and the fact that you can carry it around, it's refillable. I think those are all positives for this lip balm. Is it the best lip balm I have ever used? No. Is it one that I will be using a lot? Yes. So overall, I would recommend it. I like it, but I still don't think it is the best lip balm out there. But I really like the texture of it if you're looking for a thin, lightweight lip balm. Now, typically during the winter months, I go for something a little heavier duty on my lips, but I have found that this really does, you know, keep my lips in the condition that they're in pretty well, and it's very comfortable. And I've tried this lip balm under lipsticks and I haven't had any issues with any of the ones that I've used it under. But, you know, if you're going to apply your lip balm and then apply your lipstick immediately afterwards, definitely use a lip liner because you will have a little bit of feathering, or, well, you may have, but I experience some feathering if I wear a lip balm underneath a lip product, but it's not like blotted dry, if that makes sense. So in summation, I think it's a nice lip balm. I would repurchase it. You know, when I use this up, there's a good chance I will purchase a refill of this. I do like how it is refillable. I think the packaging is nice, but it could be improved upon. Now, in my opinion, there are really two or three categories of lip balms. So you have those that are thicker, more heavy duty, that are there for repair. And I prefer to use those overnight. You could also use like a lip mask or something like that overnight. Then you have the sheer portable ones that are easy to carry around with you. They're meant for daily use and, you know, they're just comfortable and easy to use. They will offer some hydration, but they're not going to be as reparative as something a little bit thicker. And then of course we have tinted lip balms. And I have to say, I think most tinted lip balms, they focus more on the tint than the actual lip balm category. So I think most tinted lip balms do not necessarily help improve the appearance of your lips. It's really more just a sheer lightweight wash of color. So there are two tinted lip balms that I do really like. Let's go ahead and start with those. So the two tinted lip balms that I find actually do help the condition of my lips slightly would be the Shantikai. This is the hydrating lip tint. And when this came out during the spring summer collection, this was limited edition, but it has now become permanent, I believe, due to so many people loving these. So my particular favorite shade here is Verbena. And I think it's a really nice sheer berry shade. So you can see you can get a light sheer wash of color, but you can build this up and, you know, it's just really nice. So I find that if I use these regularly, they do help maintain my lip condition and improve it slightly. And these are very comfortable on the lips and I love the color choices. There are four color options. I love all four of them. This one is my favorite along with the red one, Madeira. But I have to say I use Beach Rose more than either of them because it's technically light pink, but it's almost translucent. Next up, the other lip tint that I love is the Clé de Peau. And this is another one that does actually leave my lips in better condition. And I think it is very nice. This is the one from the holiday. This is another berry shade. So you can see here that it's gonna be similar to the Verbena, but this one's actually a little bit more of a purpley pink compared to the Shantikai one. And then I also love the coral one from the permanent line, which is this one here. It's just like a light, they call it coral, but it's really like a light melon shade in my opinion. But the Clé de Peau ones, they do have a scent and it depends on what color you get. I have not tried the original one, which is like a light pink with like a white core. I haven't tried that. I've only tried the ones that have a solid color. And I really like them. And I do find that when I use these, they do help the condition of my lips. And I find these to help a little bit more than the Shantikai ones. So picking favorites, the Clé de Peau would win. So those would be my two favorites for lip tints or tinted lip balms. But for portable translucent lipsticks, my favorites would include just something like a clear lipstick. This is from the Chanel Camelia line last year. This is number 327 Camelia Blanc. And really, it's just a clear lipstick. You can see that I use this quite frequently, but it's right here. And it's just a translucent lipstick, but I find it to be comfortable, moisturizing, and I love the packaging, so it's really nice to use. But you know, again, it's not gonna be super reparative, but keeping this on my lips does lock in moisture that I already have. So I do really like this one. And honestly, that's the only one I have for translucent portable lipsticks. The other ones I have, you know, they're okay, but I wouldn't recommend them. So they wouldn't be repurchases for me. But I do really like this one and I've been meaning to try the actual lip balm that they have as well. I haven't tried that yet, but I have heard good things about the Chanel lip balms and they have three different kinds. They have a tinted, they have a sheer portable one, and then they have one in the pot. So again, I haven't tried any of them, but I'm definitely interested. And then in the pot, I find that you have things that are typically going to be a little bit more reparative than those that are in stick form. That's not always the case if something's in the pot, but for the most part, I use these more overnight or early in the morning when I wake up because, for one thing, sanitation. You know, I don't like carrying something like this in my bag just because I want to make sure my hands are always clean when I use it. So I always put this on after washing my hands. Now, this here is the Shantikai Lip Potion. This is one that I really like. You can see I'm just about hitting pan on this. And I broke mine. So it's actually a hinge lid and it clicks closed. I've dropped this a lot and it went down the staircase. And so the first time I dropped it, I broke off the little clip here. And then this broke off. And yeah, so anyway, this is mine. But this actually has a light pearly pink. Not sure if you can see that. There's a little bit of a soft pink pearlescence to it. It's very pretty on the lips. Now, I find this one to be nice and comfortable. I will use this overnight sometimes, but I don't find it as heavy duty as some of the others. So typically, this is the one I put on first thing in the morning, but I think this is a great lip balm. When my lips are in really bad shape, I go with the By Terry Balm de Rose. And this one here, it has a strong rose scent. So I typically don't use it during the daytime because I feel like it conflicts with other products I might have on. But you can see how much thicker this is. It's very comfortable, very hydrating. And I have found that this one really does heal my lips better than other things that I've used. And then my favorite for, it's the Sisley Nutritive Lip Balm. I touched on this one in the skincare favorites. For me, it's a favorite because I really like the texture and the comfort of it. And I do find that it helps the condition of my lips, but not as much as the By Terry. So I really like this one. I need to get a new one. And then during the summer, when I don't need as much hydration, I actually really like the Biosance. This is their Rose Vegan Lip Balm, and it's a similar texture to the Sisley. You can see that it's going to be a thin balm. This one's actually a bit thinner, so it's good for light hydration, but you know, I only use this during the warmer months. And then one other thing that I constantly use anytime I really need to lock in moisture for anything, like hands, lips, whatever, Aquaphor. Just always go back to the basic Aquaphor. Now, I don't actually use the Aquaphor lip balm. If you've used the one like in the squeeze tube, you know, it's just, it's a little runny and I don't find that to be as effective. I just take the regular old Aquaphor and put that on. They sell that in little squeeze tubes too. And I use that. I usually keep that in my purse. And then I have a big tub of it as well. And if my hands are super dry at night, I put on hand cream. And then Aquaphor on top of that and put on some, you know, moisturizing gloves. So I find Aquaphor to be a great, I don't know if it's actually a humectant, but it really does lock everything in and keep everything in there. So it's kind of like a go-to for me for blocking out anything that could potentially dry out my skin. And just a note, if you are going out in really, really cold, snowy weather, putting Aquaphor on your face before going out really does wonders. Works great on kids too. So just another use for Aquaphor, which I find to be wonderful. So that sums up all of my favorite lip balms. Again, there are a lot of lip balms out there that I haven't tried. There are also many that I have tried that haven't made the cut. So if you're curious about a particular one, please let me know. I'll let you know if I've tried that out before. I can tell you right now, the La Neige ones that people always talk about, I have not tried those yet. So they are on my list to try at some point, but I haven't gotten around to it yet. And that's everything for today. So I hope this was helpful. I'd love to know down below what your thoughts are on the Dior lip balm and what your favorite lip balm is. I'm always looking to try new ones. I absolutely love lip balms. So, you know, I usually keep quite a few around. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. And don't forget, for Makeup Mondays, we are all about answering your questions. And if you have any questions you would like to enter for another episode of Makeup Mondays, please leave that down below in the comments. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you soon.